Hey everyone, it's Frank here, and today is the final week of Ultraman Great Month, as well as the final review. As you can tell by the title, we're going to take a look at the final villain in the series, Kilazee. Now, again, this is the DreamWorks Kilazee, not the Bandai Kilazee. There are a few differences between the two, but mostly, this one just has a nicer looking paint job, and it's just bigger. The other one, it looks nice, but, you know, obviously, if you just want something a little more eye-catching, you're going to want to go with the DreamWorks one. Now, unlike most of my other figures, excluding Bogan, this one came in the box with this little sticker. So I get to show it off, yay! Kilazee! Yeah, apparently in Japan, his name is pronounced as Shirelee or something like that, but basically, you know, it's Kilazee. Just, you know, just go with it. So yeah, he comes with a little sticker, big deal. Now, one thing you'll notice about the figure right away is that it's quite a lot bigger than most figures usually are. As I said before in the previous videos, the DreamWorks figures are a little bigger than normal, so they're not like 6 inches. This guy is pretty big. For comparison, here is Bandai's Ultraman. And, yeah, you can see he literally just towers Ultraman. Just, I mean, look at that. He's just downright puny compared to Kilazee. Massive figure, and this is pretty close to what it was in the TV show. I think maybe Ultraman was a little smaller, kind of like this, but that's really just because he was kind of crouching, you know, when we're fighting him, but whatever. So this looks pretty cool. Nice big imposing kaiju for once, you know, not having him, you know, having it freaking like this, you know? So yeah, that's the sizing. In case you don't have, well, why wouldn't you have Ultraman? Here is just for fun, the Monster Arts Godzilla, and oh, what's this doing out here? Oops. You didn't see anything. Anywho, here's Monster Arts Godzilla. And as well, he just plain towers Godzilla. So yeah, if you want to have a big epic kaiju fight with, you know, something other than King Ghidorah, you know, because he's kind of got that whole space dragon thing going for him, you have an alternative in Kilazee here. And luckily, unlike King Ghidorah figures most of these days, he's pretty cheap. Even in the box, really. So yeah, I say, you know, already, I know it's just the beginning of the review, but I'm already saying pick this guy up. He's, I don't know, he's just sweet. So yeah. Articulation, these fig, this probably, he's not very articulated, but he's got a few. Arms can obviously move up and down, just like that. The legs, they don't move, they move in and out, like this. You know, like, I don't know why you would do that, and that looks really wrong. Yeah, I guess, I don't know, maybe you want to adjust his feet for balance? I'm not sure. But you can rotate the legs like that, maybe if you want to have them stand like this? I'm not sure. But really, just kind of leave it like this. There's no reason to ever move them, like, ever. Yeah, he's got his hand too. The neck, it's really stiff. I don't know if they glue sealed it. Well, no, they didn't glue seal mine. But he can turn it a little bit. But it's really not meant to move, because it clashes with the inner rings of the other limbs. Like, a tail here. It tails, well, it's not really much of a tail, but it can move up and down or rotate like that. So yeah, just, whatever. Now, the wings don't move either, but I want to mention the wings first of all. If you have this figure, or you've seen it online, you probably noticed, hey, the wings on your figure are spread out. Why is that? Well, the reason is because I've actually switched figures, you know, from the left and right sockets. You know, usually Kilazee is like, you know, kind of like this, but more so, they're like almost parallel to the, you know, the tail here. So they're basically folded back and they can never move. So what I did is I took them out and I switched them around. And so now he looks like he's got them out for flying. Ooh. So yeah. If you want to try this, I'd recommend just using a hair dryer and just kind of, you know, using it to make the vinyl really soft and squishy, so it'll be able to, you know, put them in and out without, you know, breaking anything, because the vinyl is really stiff on this guy. Despite being, you know, a hollow vinyl figure, they are pretty, you know, they're pretty sturdy. So obviously you use a hair dryer, make the vinyl soft, and put the wings in, and there you go, you've got a flying Kilazee. Oh, well, actually, yeah, that's perfect, flying Kilazee, just like that. I suppose they're having them folded, you know, really kind of ugly looking. And so, yeah. When I was to the paint job, like I said, this is much more colorful than the Bandai Kilazee, which is basically just red and silver with maybe some color for the eyes, and that's about it. As you can see, this one isn't just red. He's got some black here for these little, whatchacallits there. some interesting, you know, just interesting color choices all around, you know, for the hands. Yeah, these actually do shoot little laser beams or missiles or whatever. I'm not sure if I got some, you know, black to give the figure a little more color. Nothing back here except the wings, of course. You know, I really like the way they do with the wings. They got the black color, you know, they got some orange on top, and then they got the green in between. It makes the figure really pop, you know. It's very eye-catching. The red catches your eye, and you just look at the colors like, wow, that's a pretty figure. Unfortunately, the face doesn't fare so well. He's got the traditional Ultraman grid eyes, the kind of snake yellow eyes, and some yellow on the teeth, but that's really it. Oh well, for such a cheap, simple figure, this is pretty good. I forget how much I paid for this. I'd say I paid about $20 for this guy. He's pretty cool. And at that price, you know, hey, you can't go wrong. Bandai one goes about a little more, maybe, you know, with a tag, but really, I say, get this guy. You know, I'm not saying don't get the Bandai one. In fact, I'd probably want to get the Bandai one someday too, just to compare. But this, you know, on its own, it's cheap, it's cool looking, and it just looks fantastic. Well, cool and fantastic look. It's big. That, you know, that's a big thing. So, yeah, let me size up. Let me just get the other Ultraman Great monsters out here. And there we go. There are all the Ultraman Great kaiju from the DreamWorks set. And as you can see, all together they make just a really nice display. So, yeah, overall, this is kind of concludes, you know, all the DreamWorks kaiju I have. And they're, I don't know, they're just top notch. Anyone who really says these figures aren't that good, well, I don't know. I'm kind of wondering, you know, what kind of taste you have in figures. Because, you know, they're cheap, they look cool, they've got articulation, they're big, you know, they're scaling up well with the Ultras here. Just, you know, look at him, he's puny compared to all of them. And, you know, they're all in scale with the Bandai line, so what's to complain about? I mean, you're basically getting high quality stuff, well, maybe not high quality, but, you know, you're basically getting Bandai level stuff from this time, and it's, you know, look great. So, you know, yeah, that kind of concludes the Ultraman Great, you know, line here. I mean, obviously we don't have the Bandai one, you know, ones, but whatever. So yeah, Majama, Garukadon, Kilazee, Bogan, and Varangus. 5 wonderful kaiju from the DreamWorks set that are pretty underrated, if I have to say anything about it. And, yeah, that's all about I got for you guys. Before I wrap this up, let's just go right onto the detail real quick. As with all the other figures, he's got, you know, nice detail. He's very well textured. A lot of work, obviously, put into these figures, you know, more so than you would think for something that costs, you know, $12 to $20. You know, brand new in box. And they just look fantastic. I mean, look at that. There's texture all over, and there isn't just, you know, the texture here. He also got some little more, you know, they look like barbs, you know, almost like a stingray at the end here. I don't know if that's part of the design or they just added that, you know, as they tended to do with these guys, but whatever. The hands, you know, the little missile hands. Nothing really on the wings. They're pretty smooth, but they do look cool. They got kind of a bony structure to them here. So, yeah, he's just, you know, fantastic, as are all the great figures from this line. Get a look at the face now, look at that. It's a mean-ass face, and it looks just sweet. A little closer there, yeah, there you go. Look at the teeth, they look pretty cartoony, but what are you gonna do? How else would you mold it, you know? And so that concludes the end of this review, as well as the end of Ultraman Great Month. As far as Kilazee goes, I would say he's probably, I don't know, he's just, I want to say he's like the second or third best, but they're all really great figures, say for maybe a Majaba, maybe. But he still looks cool anyway. Kilazee is just, you know, again, one of these really great kaiju that just kind of goes underrated. Not just the figure, but the monster itself. I mean, it's big, it's in scale, it's got great detail, great sculpting, it's got some decent articulation, and it looks beautiful. The paint job is just, it's vibrant and it stands out. Like it's, you know, it's eye-catching. And it's just a really standout figure. I mean, it's too bad more people don't really have these, you know, DreamWorks Ultra Kaiju. But hopefully my reviews will change that. And hopefully Ultraman Great Month in general will change that. I mean, come on, I mean, just look at him. Compared to, you know, your Ultraman Hero series Ultraman, he's freaking huge. And it just looks, I don't know, I really dig this figure. So if you haven't already, I suggest picking up all these Ultra Rank Great figures, you know, on eBay. You can probably find them for really cheap, even in a box. I mean, they're really cheap. That's the deal breaker. These guys are cheap. Even at a lot, you know, with the Dreamworks Ultra Rank, you're probably looking at maybe $50 to $80, maybe. These guys are cheap, and, you know, the value is just great. I won't be getting the Dreamworks Series Ultraman Great, just so anyone, you know, you guys know. Probably because I really don't care for it. It looks kind of goofy, and it's obviously out of scale with them. It's the same size as them, so that's kind of the problem. I mean, I'll probably maybe one day get Ultraman Great from the Bandai line, you know, like this Ultraman here, but that's probably not going to happen, so whatever. But I don't need them. I just, you know, I came for the Kaiju because they're the stars here. So Kilazee is going to get a 5/5 once again. You know, there's just really nothing wrong with it. Even the articulation is pretty good. You know, he can move the arms and add legs, tail, and he can twist the head a little. And if you get the wings spread out like I did, you got, you know, a brilliant flying Kaiju. So yeah, that's about all I got for you guys. Hope you enjoyed this little project I did of Ultraman Great Month. And hopefully next time when things are a little, less hectic around here, I'll get to this guy. Oh yeah, I can't wait either. So yeah, I'll see you guys later, and take care.